A little over a year ago, I uploaded my first video to this channel, where I made a microscope out of a webcam by turning the optics around. I managed to get a magnification of around 500 times, which is pretty good given that the webcam only cost around $10. In the original video, I used the webcam microscope to look at objects that I had lying around the house, like these dust fibers. Now, dust fibers are cool and all, but they're far from the most exciting thing that you can see with a microscope. For this video, I decided that I wanted to try and find some microbes. The first issue was to try and find a setup that would keep something that small visible and in focus. On a commercial microscope, so-called bright field images are made by shining a bright light through a thin sample held on a transparent surface, usually a glass microscope slide. From there, the light travels through the microscope's optics where it eventually reaches your camera or your eye, forming the magnified image. To replicate this as simply as possible, I decided that I would point my microscope up at the bulb of a standing gooseneck lamp, and then place the sample in water on a transparent plastic takeout container lid. I found this convenient piece of an old dishwasher to use as a stand for the sample, and I clipped the microscope to the leg of a stool to hold it steady. I still wasn't entirely sure that this setup would work, so before I went out to collect a real sample with microbes in it, I decided to test it by looking at some particles of silt. This test turned out really well. I was able to keep the silt in focus and well lit. I also decided to look at the pixels on my phone to get a good measurement of the scale with this setup, just like I did in the original microscope video. There are 1,080 pixels across the 7 cm width of my phone, so each of these pixels is 70 microns in size. According to the Wentworth grain size scale, silt is from about 4 to 62 microns across, so the sample I was looking at earlier definitely qualifies. So for scale, remember that the whole screen is about 400 microns across. With the system working, it was time to find some microbes. I figured the best place to look would be the pond at my local park, so I went over and picked up some pond water. I tried to make sure to get some dirt particles and some plant matter in the sample, since those might be cool to look at and might be home to some microbes. With the sample in hand, I spooned some pond water onto my setup and started taking video. At first I wasn't seeing any motion, but the plant parts looked pretty interesting by themselves. Looking at the sample with my eye, I thought I saw something tiny jittering around, so I was pretty sure that there was life in my sample. It was just a matter of finding it with the microscope. Finally, after a long time watching bits of moss, I caught a small black dot racing around in the lower left of my frame. We found a microbe! It wasn't really that great of a picture, but it was a start. After fiddling around with the setup, I started getting some much better images. The next living creature that I saw was this bluish guy, which seemed to be anchored to something and flailing around. Judging by the shape of what looks like its mouth, it might be a rotifer, but it looks a little too small for that. In this shot, you can see a little lemon-shaped cell hiding in the plant matter. You can see its organelles, so it's definitely a eukaryote of some sort. This shot has a multicellular organism in it. It looks a little like the end of some sort of worm. The largest organism in this shot is probably a diatom, and the smaller two look like some kind of ciliate based on how they're moving. These little organisms were very common in this sample. Overall, I'm really happy with how this turned out. Not only were the microbes visible, but we could even see some details smaller than the cellular level. My next goal for this microscope is to find some tardigrades, but I'm probably going to wait until the spring to go and find those, since it will be easier to gather the moss where they live if there's no snow on the ground. Until then, I hope you enjoyed this microscopic adventure. And as always, thanks for watching.